All right, guys. Hey, welcome to my new video. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my process. Yeah, I'm going to be talking about a few things while watching me painting in the background, obviously. Anyway, so so for this painting, I don't know if you have been following me on social media, Facebook, Instagram. You see that I have been posting these daily drawing, you know, posts, like drill daily studies. It's something I'm trying to work on, and I want to see the end results. So basically, that's what this one was. I think this is day 3, and I'm still on this challenge. I hope I can finish it up. I love commissions. Anyway, so for this piece, so I just, you know, did my normal sketch, which was, as you can see, very normal. Just look at your reference and try and draw, but this might be kind of difficult for beginners to pull off, because there's a lot of stuff you don't understand. As you can see from my sketch, I'm stylizing the sketch right away. Like, the character in, you know, the picture, the reference is pretty normal, and then the one I have in my drawing has bigger eyes, bigger head, and everything is just stylized. So you need to have an understanding of realism first before you can do this. I don't want to talk about this. I already talked about it in my previous video. You can check it out. Anyway, so it's very important to actually have a good sketch down, because if you don't do this, you would struggle in the painting process, at least in my opinion. Although I don't always do this though, but I think I really needed to understand, you know, how the braids and everything worked, so I had to do this sketch anyway. So this is just me sketching. So there are a few things I want to talk about while this is going on, and I'll be still talking about my process. Number one is lighting. I got a lot of questions on Facebook, like how I approach lighting, how I light my characters, and it's very it's a broad topic, you know, lighting, and it's also, I'm not sure I can treat everything in this video, but what I would say is that, number one, what is light? I think we need to understand that. So light is, it's the energy in a very simple and stylized definition. It's basically the energy that makes us see the world around us. So without light, there wouldn't be sight. Like, you wouldn't be able to see things like color. You wouldn't be able to see things like, how you won't be able to see anything. Basically, that's just what light is. It helps us to see things, so we can perceive colors and perceive objects. We know how objects are because there's light. So when you understand that it is light that reveals, you know, an object's form, you would approach lighting with a more practical approach. Anyway, so when I understood this, I began to implement into my work. So you see me creating a new layer, and the first thing I do, like, once I block out the mask for my character, I paint in my lights, like on a separate layer, maybe an overlay or linear dodge or color dodge or even hard light, depending on what I want. So when you understand that, so light is is an energy that reveals, you know, that makes us see the world around us. That's what we really need to know, majorly. So where there is light, we can see stuff. Where there is light, we can see color. Light also reveals the form of an object. It makes us perceive things, you know, and know that they are there. So that's what light is. So when you're lighting your portraits, let's come back to art now. When you're lighting your portrait, it means you need to understand what your light source is, how intense it is, and where it's coming from. Then you talk about purpose. Why is light source there? Because you're an artist, all right? You don't just do things because, okay, I'm just going to put this here now. No. If you do that, you'll be having a lot of accidents. Some of them might be happy, some of them might not be so successful. So you need to understand your light source. Okay, so in my image and in my painting, I have my reference up here, which is going to serve as a guide for me, like, so I don't just go painting what I think is there and paint what is actually there. Now you look at my light source and I'm like, okay, this is obviously a sunlight. All right, so the major source of light, you know, why this character is not in complete darkness is because there is a light source, and the major light source is from the sun. And I can see that the sun is at the top right corner, you know, in a direction that we can see showing on the character. So when you understand where the light is coming from, it means that the shadows are going to be in the opposite, the major shadows are going to be in the opposite direction. So now that she's being backlit, that is, most of the light is going to be hitting her back and less of the light is going to be, the stronger light source is going to be at the front. Now, when you have something like that, what's left is your ambient light. All right. I really hope I could explain everything well, but I'll link some tutorials. All right. Some tutorials I use to even understand these things better. If you know Marco Bucci, I would link some of his tutorials. He has a lot of, you know, tutorials on this topic. So, but what you need to understand is, study your reference properly and see that you see in this reference, all right, that it's not just one light source. And if it was just one light source, her entire front will be in shadow. I would advise us to actually carry out this study. Like, once in our, as you're going out, don't just go out like that. As in, while you're outdoors, just look at how the sunlight lights up everywhere, lights up the environment. You see that. Why are the shadows blue? Have you asked yourself why shadows are blue? Well, the reason why they are blue is because, like, under sunlight, is because ambient light from the clouds hides in the shadows. Because the major light source is strong, all other light sources have to hide in the shadows. So, for this, our portrait now, you see that we have our major warm sunlight, and then what exactly is lighting up the rest of the face? Why are we seeing the other side of face? Isn't it supposed to be in like shadow, like dark shadow? Well, the reason is because of bounced sunlight. It's obvious that whoever took this photo had, obviously it was a photo shoot, so there was something bouncing the sunlight back to the face of the character. So you see that it's even giving this kind of like underlit kind of lighting. If you check the top of her eyes, you see that there's light hitting that top. So understanding that the light is bouncing around. So light travels in straight lines and it bounces around a lot. So that's why you hear the term bounced light. All right. Oh boy, this is really going to be difficult to explain everything I know about lighting. But I think that these are the basic things. Just understand, remember, the purpose of that light source. Is that light source going to emphasize something about the character? Is it the color of the light too? Like mood, like how does the character feel at that time? You see, this light source now gives you a very energetic, you know, happy kind of light, kind of mood to you as you're viewing this. It doesn't give you, you know, something like, oh, fear or indecision or confusion or something. It's positive. It's positive, you know, energy. That's what this light setting, this light, what gives this kind of lighting gives the viewer. Okay, was to use something like say a red light source, you'd feel immediately maybe afraid, or like, okay, this character is evil. Maybe her smile would be, and if I change the angle of her smile, it would be an evil smile, like an evil character who's seemingly innocent, that kind of, you know, vibe. So you see how important light is. This light in the image now kind of also cuts out the character from the background. You can see that the clothes she's wearing is kind of very similar to the background she's on, like, but with the light it has changed a lot of things. You see that most of the shirt is now having a different color because it's partially in shadow, and then there's a bounce light, and then the rim light, that is the light from the sun now, the major lights, intense light source, now cuts up the character from the background, you know, and clearly separate the silhouette on the background. So you have to understand, like, what is the purpose of this light source. And maybe I would create a separate video in the future, like, to explain purpose of light, like what lights can actually do. But for this image, I'm just breaking down the lighting for this image, and there's really not much to it, like shadow and light. I think I talked about this in my previous tutorial. Maybe I'll do let me know what you guys think, okay, like what you want me to talk about exactly. Like, let me just dedicate a specific video for it, because this was just a speed paint and I'm just like adding a commentary to it and all. So I'm gonna stop here right now, and let me know if this video was useful. I don't know if it was, but I think it was, and what you would like to see me post more often, right, in my next videos. All right, so please enjoy the rest of the paint. Till next time.
Calmly feel myself evolving, appalling, so much I'm not divulging. Been stalling, I think I hear applauding, they're calling. Mixtapes aren't my thing, but it's been awfully exhausting. Hanging on to songs as long as daunting, which caused me to have to make a call I thought was ballsy, resulting in what you see today. Proceed indulging, as always, the one trick pony's here, so quit your sulking. Born efficient, got ambition, sort of vicious, yep, that's me. Not artistic, unrealistic, chauvinistic, not those things. Go the distance, so prolific, postal cryptic, move swiftly, unsubmissive, the king of mischief, the golden ticket, rare sight to see. I stay committed, embrace the rigid, I'm playful with it, yeah, basically. Too great to mimic, you hate your bitter, no favoritism, that's fine with me. Create the riddles, portrayed in civil, unsafe a little, oh yes indeed, it's plain and simple, I'm far from brittle, unbreakable, you following? I'm Bruce Willis in a train wreck, I'm like trading in your car for a new jack. I'm like having a boss getting upset, cause you asked him for less on your paycheck. I'm like doing headstands with a broke neck, I'm like watching your kid take his first steps. I'm like saying Bill Gates couldn't pay rent cause it's too broke. Where am I going with this? Unbelievable, yes, yes, inconceivable. See myself as fairly reasonable, but at times I can be stubborn, so if I have to, I will rock the boat. I don't tend to take the easy road, that's just not the way I like to roll. What you think's probably unfeasible, I've done already a hundredfold, it's probable that I might press the envelope. Ideas so astronomical, sometimes I find them comical. Yeah, incomparable, replay value phenomenal, beat selection remarkable, slowing me down impossible. I don't rock no rollies, I don't hang around no phonies, I don't really got no trophies, I don't know why God chose me. Got something in the cup, ain't codeine, changed my style, they told me. Now they come around like, homie, man, y'all better back up slowly. Back up slowly? Who are you kidding? How could you doubt me? I've always delivered. Ripping the teeth out of the back of my mouth. The closer you get to my wisdom, see my initial thought was the way. But what can I say? I had to come visit, check on you guys. You doing all right? You're yearly socked. Yeah, that's what I figured. They cover their heads up whenever I drop. Shake the whole industry, put them in shock. Come out the clouds like a meteor rock. Then land on the earth like ready or not. Ain't no one like me to cream me the crop. Don't even front, but they give me some props. I'll pick up your body and throw it a block. Okay, I admit it, that's over the top. Not
here in the headlight looks. Every time I step my foot on the ground, I get mistook for a lame with no weight to his name. Ground just shook, let's not beat around the bush. Even my B-sides throw him off like how's he do it. Some say I'm a great influence, I don't know about that, but I did do the best I could. Hollywood, Hollywood, hope Nate doesn't go.